Welcome, happy campers. It's me, Amanda, here with Cookeville RV and Marine, and today we're taking a look into this 2022 Flagstaff 19BH, and this is a E-Pro. I'm so excited to get started on this, so let's go. Here we are in the outside entertainment space of this cute E-Pro. A few things I want to point out. We do have a power awning, and it has an LED light strip underneath it that spans the entire length of the awning. There's a few other features like this frameless windows here, and check out this doorknob. It has a code added into it. A little bit extra security. You don't have to have your keys on you at all times. Of course, we have our grab handle that stores for travel, and these steps do fold into the camper just so they don't get caught in the wind while you're going down the road. But before we head to the storage, don't forget, give this video a like, hit that subscribe button and that bell notification icon so you get notified when we post a new video. But let's get going. Here we are in our pass-through storage of this E-Pro. It may be small, but it is mighty. We have two LED lights under here with just an on and off feature, but it is fully finished and it's super easy to clean. It's a good place to keep any of the extra accessories you may have, including ones that can go on this outside entertainment space, such as a table. But you may not be able to put a bike down here, but they have extra storage for that, don't worry. What may not be in our pass-through storage is all of our hookups for our city water connections and everything else. We have an outdoor shower on this side as well, which is the opposite side from our entrance. Here's our power source, and check out this secret door here. Remember when I talked about bike storage? It's in here. Okay, here I am inside this Flagstaff. One of the things I see when I first walk in is my control panel here to my left. Is that good eyesight and has all my lights, my awning and my pumps and all the switches that you need. To my right, we have our entertainment space over our bed here that has a TV on a swivel. We have some extra Wi-Fi power and our indoor-outdoor speaker system, which is super awesome. But let's talk about this bed. We have a residential size bed here that is particularly comfy. It is on a platform, and as you can notice, this platform is covered all the way with carpet. So it's just a little bit of something to help this mattress not slide. Also, right next to our bed, a charging tower here with two outlets and two USB ports there as well. Above me, you can see we have some cubby style storage, and for your wardrobe down here bottom, we've got two large drawers that do pull out, as well as under our dinette, we have some more storage if you need some extra space for your clothes. Moving along to our dinette option, I love this super cute diner style dinette. It's super comfortable. These pads are really thick. This does transform into a sleeping area. All you have to do is take this pole out. You can slide it underneath there, but this just lays on the extra supports here. And then you put these extra cushions over top. And this is a pretty good space for maybe a smaller adult or child to sleep in. Next to this dinette, we have a nice big window here that is an emergency exit as well. Again, one thing I want to point out is the quality of these shades. I like it when they make things that block out light, but you're not gonna worry about it breaking or getting caught when you use it all the time, because I know I do. Above me, as you can see, we have more storage behind some heavy duty doors. I really like the quality of those. And just pretty much for anything else you need, wardrobe, supplies for hiking or outdoor adventure, there's plenty of options here. Also right next to me is our bunks. And here we are next to our bunks. So we have two twin size bunks here. Each has their own light and its own switch. The top one has a nice window with a shade, and the bottom one has that access door. Now, what's that door for? Well, underneath this bottom bunk is so much storage. And if you check out underneath here, we have extra hinges, and you can even flip this bottom bunk over to add a bike or anything else you want to pack in here if you don't necessarily need this bunk while you're traveling. And underneath here is our ladder as well if you needed that. But I know I personally could probably just use the bottom bunk as a lift up into the top, as it's probably about 4 feet tall. It's really not too tall, but I am 5'11", so not very accurate for the majority of people. I am a giant. Moving on to our kitchen area. So we have dinette little area for our stove and our sink. Check out this really cute stainless steel inset square sink. I like that they added the drying rack option on top. Again, this has grips, so it's not going anywhere when you hit the road. Stainless steel swivel faucet. Lots of storage up here. You can fit a full-size dinner plate in there. Maybe not some serving trays, but you can have your own for you and your friends to have some dishes for you. Here we have a little extra storage for all of our soaps, sponges for when you do those dishes, and a smaller drawer here for our utensils, which they do add a utensil holder in there already, so you don't have to purchase one. We have a 3-burner top Magic Chef. Yes, Magic Chef stove here, again with this splash guard. I really like they put that on there just so you don't get anything on your blinds. And then down below, a little bit more storage space. You could probably get some organizers down there for some of your extra pots and pans. Moving on, we have our Magic Chef microwave here, as well as another Magic Chef refrigerator. While it is small, it is mighty. You've got plenty of space here, and the fridge is really big, and they give you extra storage for your cans, your wine bottles. There's plenty of storage there for a full weekend's worth of food, and it does set and lock to travel as well. Okay, I'm currently standing in our bathroom of this tiny Flagstaff, but it is so cute. We have a full-size shower here that also has a tub insert. So say you've got kids or a dog or anyone else that would like to take a bath or even soak some items. Maybe you went hiking, need to soak some shoes, get the mud off. This is super awesome to use for dual purpose. We have a removable shower head here, and our sink is in our shower as well, just to maximize space. But it's definitely useful because even if you stand outside the shower, you can still use it. To my left here, we have our foot flush toilet. They added a little bit of a toothbrush holder and a spot for your styling tools. And they even added a mirror here, already added to this wall, just to make sure you don't have to add one in yourself. And it's plenty big for someone, maybe not two people, but for someone to use. And then again, more storage here for any extra linens or any extra towels or products. This is a pretty good place. We also have a vent fan in this bathroom, just in case you wanna make sure that the humidity doesn't get all built up. But what do you think about this Flagstaff? Any questions for us? Give us a call or visit us online at cookvillerv.com, where your adventure awaits.